So hi everyone, welcome to Smart Hobbies YouTube channel. So in this video we're going to see how to hatch these Artemia brine shrimp eggs. It's a very simple setup guys, you can easily make this at your home and this is 100% successful. Today I will be using this brand called Salt Lake Artemia and this brand called Pegan. This brand is available in Amazon. I'll try to send the link in the description box below. So make sure to try it out at home. And I'm going to also discuss some basic points about these Artemia brine shrimp eggs. I'm going to tell you the uses of Artemia brine shrimp. So let's get into the setup. So guys, before doing the setup, I would like to discuss some basic points about these Artemia brine shrimps as to why you use them. So in case you have betta fries, guppy fries, zebra danios fries, those fries are very small. You cannot feed them any random fish fry food. You need to feed them live feed, which is very small, like this Artemia brine shrimp. You cannot feed them any random fish fry food as it will not be able to digest it and it will die. It will not eat the food only in the first place. So make sure when you have fries, you feed them this Artemia brine shrimp as it is good for their growth as well as it gives them a long life. And another use is if you want to breed your betta fish or guppy fish, they need food high in protein. And this Artemia brine shrimp is definitely high in protein and it definitely helps the fish to breed. So this is some basic points I wanted to tell you all before getting into the setup, because many people don't know why they use this and they just simply end up buying and they just waste it. So now I'm going to show you the complete setup. So for this, first you need a big jar like this. This is approximately 700 liters and a small glass jar and a bottle which is cut like this and some rock salt. This is the most important, and some stick to just mix it. And most importantly, you need this Artemia brine shrimp. I have two brands. I'll use half of each. You can use any one, it's enough. I have two, so I'm using two, little. So the first thing you do is add some rock salt to the water. So right now this has no role to play. This is the most important one for now. So first you add little bit of rock salt. Look at the amount I'm adding. That much is enough. And next is this. I'm going to add some Artemia brine shrimp. This is the most important one. That's it. I'm gonna close it and give it back safely. Next is I'm gonna add the Pegan one. This box, guys don't care about this box. I have a Pegan thing inside. So this is the Pegan brand. This is actually, I used half before, I'm going to use the other half now. That's it guys, not more, and keep it back. And now finally we give it a good mix. Thank you.
So guys, after adding the brine shrimp eggs, you keep it in such a place where you adjust a bulb next to the setup, a bright bulb like this, so that the Artemia brine shrimp eggs get some heat and light. Only if there's heat and light, the Artemia brine shrimp eggs will hatch. And the other thing is, you need to keep an air motor, and there should be airflow in the water so that there's some movement in the water, because these Artemia brine shrimp eggs are collected from the sea, and the sea always have some kind of movement, right? So here also there should be some movement. So that's the reason we have an air stone inside, which gives air bubbles, and the water, and because of air bubbles, the water will always be in a movement, it will always be in a motion. So remember guys, when you switch on the motor, the airflow should not be too large or too less. It should be in the correct medium, because if the airflow is too large, more force will be there, will be more rapid movement in the water, and if this happens, the brine shrimp eggs will not hatch. So this is a point you'll have to remember. And after you switch on the motor, you'll have to wait for 24 hours for the eggs to hatch, that is one full day. So now let's switch on the motor. So the airflow should be something like this, not too big or not too small, and you can see there's some constant movement in the water. It should be like this, the whole setup should be like this after you add the brine shrimp and the rock salt in water. Okay, so let's meet after 24 hours. So guys, after the Artemia eggs have hatched, you need to use a bottle like this. Guys, at starting I told you'll have to use a bottle which is cut, but guys, you should not use that, I'm very sorry, that was by mistake. You'll need to use a proper bottle like this, and the cap should have a small hole over here. Okay, now let me show you what has to be done. So guys, now you transfer all the Artemia to this bottle. So let me carefully transfer it. So guys, I have transferred everything. Now let me close this. So now guys, you take this a small glass container, you fill it with aquarium water. Guys, do not fill it with normal water, please fill it with aquarium water. And now what you have to do is to just invert this bottle. So now all the Artemia will come down and get collected separately in this glass container, and all the eggshells will remain in the bottle. That's why we do this. We should not feed the eggshells to the fish, as it can cause various diseases. So guys, I'll turn off the lights now. It's actually daytime, so it's a little bright. Artemia is attracted to torch light. So what you need to do is, I'm using another phone and put a torch here. And you leave this for something like 10 minutes for all the Artemia to get collected in this glass container. So guys, all the Artemia is getting collected in the glass container. This process will take some 10 to 15 minutes. So let's wait for 10 to 15 minutes. So guys, you can see the Artemia coming down from the bottle cap. It's coming slowly. See, I can see another one coming down. So like this, only all the Artemia will get collected in this. Only the Artemia will be collected and can feed this easily to your fish. In many videos, they tell you should use a separate net to catch the Artemia and freeze the Artemia. That's all too difficult. Here you just need to do this setup. It's very simple, guys. So let's wait for 10 minutes. So guys, now 10 to 15 minutes is over. So now let me show you the Artemia properly. So first, let's remove the torch.
Let's carefully remove the bottle. And now let me zoom it and show you the RTM here. Just a minute, guys. See, you can see the RTM here moving. You can see it clearly, right? It's all the RTM. Look at these microorganisms. It's so small. I can feed this to your betta fish directly. Let me on the light and show you. You can see so much of artemia. So now I'm going to feed this to my guppy fry tank. So guys, this is not a tank, but for now I've just kept some guppy fries here. This is my own guppy fries. So you can see these are some guppy fries. The water is a little dirty actually, I have to change it. So now let's add some artemia into this. Okay, so I've added some artemia. Let me zoom it and show you. So all the artemia is gone. Is inside this. Well, the water is a little foggy, so I don't think so it's so visible, but the guppy fries are eating it. The guppy fries are eating it. Now let's add this to my betta fish, my male betta fish. So this is my male betta fish. I'm going to add some here. And this is my female betta fish. So that's it, the video, guys. You can see how simple it is. Now there's another simple way to do this RTMA setup. So first, instead of using this jar and then transferring into this bottle, it might be a little difficult work. So what I can do is I can directly put some water, put artemia, put salt and mix it, and you can put an air stone. Now why I didn't do that is because I had a very big air stone. It didn't fit inside the bottle. So I had to put it in this jar and then transfer it to the bottle. If you have a small air stone, you can put it inside the bottle and can directly after the artemia is hatched, you can directly put it upside down and collect all the artemia. It's a very simple, guys. You can do it easily at your home. So guys, I hope you like this video. Please if you like this, please give a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. See you in another great video. Till then, goodbye and take care.